Hello everyone, in this video tutorial I am going to explain few more problems on equilibrium of forces. The 10th question is like this: calculate the reaction exerted at the contact point A, B, C and D as shown in the figure. Both spheres are identical. So first I am going to draw the free body diagram at P. So they given weight of the sphere, that is 30 kg. We know that 1 kg is equal to 9.81 newton. Therefore 30 kg is equal to, we can do the cross multiplication, therefore this is equal to 30 into 9.81, 294.3 newton. So I'm going to draw the free body diagram at P first. So whatever the load, that is 294.3 newton, it is acting downward. Then after that we have to check it is going to contact on how many surfaces. Now in this case it is going to contact on C and D. So because of the weight, action will be in this direction. So I was explaining we are concentrating on reaction in the opposite direction, that is towards the center of the sphere. So whatever the reaction coming from C, I will take it as RC. Whatever the reaction coming from D, I will take it as RD. Now we have to find the angle. For that I am going to complete this triangle. So this is the radius, this will be the tangent. So the angle between radius and tangent, that is 90 degree, therefore I can take this as 90 degree. So total angle of the triangle, that is 180 degree. Therefore remaining is 180 minus 90 minus 50, that will be 40 degree. Therefore RC will make an angle 40 degree with the horizontal. So instead of applying RC here, I will shift in the line of action of force, because my intention is to apply Lamy's theorem. So if I shift in the this line of action, so I can draw that RC here. This is RC, which makes an angle 40 degree with the horizontal. The next force, that is RD, instead of applying here that RD, I will shift in the line of action of force, I will draw here. So now angle of RD, they given the spheres are identical. So if I draw one line from O to P which is parallel to BC, therefore if these two lines are parallel like this, that is OP and BC, so if BC makes an angle 50 degree with the horizontal, then OP also makes an angle 50 degree with the horizontal. Therefore I will take this as 50 degree, which is RD. So to apply Lamy's theorem, I have to find the other angles, that is nothing but angle between two forces. So this angle will be 180 minus 40 minus 50, that is 90 degree. Also whatever the weight, it is always acting vertically downward, therefore with the horizontal it makes an angle 90 degree. Here also it makes an angle 90 degree. Therefore total angle between RC and that vertical force, that is 90 plus 40, I can take it as 130. Then on the other side, that is 90 plus 50, therefore total angle is 140 degree. Now I am going to apply Lamy's theorem on point P. First, I'm going to consider known force, that is 294.3 Newton, divided by angle between other two forces. Other two forces for 294, that is RC and RD, angle between them is 90 degree. Therefore, sine of the angle between other two forces, that is sine 90, that is equal to the next force I am going to consider, that is RD. For RD, other two forces are 294.3 and RC, angle between them is 130. Therefore, I can take sine 130. That is equal to the last force, that is RC. Other two forces are RD and 294.3. So, angle between them is 140. Therefore, sine 140. So, after applying Lamy's theorem, I am going to consider equation 1 and equation 2. I can solve for RD. RD is equal to 294.3 into sine 130 divided by sine 90. Therefore, RD we will get 225.44 Newton. Now I am going to consider other two equations, that is equation number 1 and equation number 3. So I want to calculate RC. Therefore, 294.3 into sine 140 divided by sine 90. So we will get 189.17 Newton. So I solved all the reactions at point P. Now I'm going to draw the free body diagram at O. So I'm considering that point O. First I'm going to consider weight of that sphere. So weight we got 294.3, 30 kg. If I convert that into Newton, that is 294.3 Newton. Then we have to check the contact surfaces. In this case we have D, B and A. Therefore, one reaction coming towards the center from B, I can take this as RB. Then one more reaction from D towards the center, that is RD. Then one more reaction from A, that is RA. So whatever coming from RD, I'm going to shift in the line of action. Then I'm going to draw here, that is RD. Next, after that, one reaction is coming from RB. I taken here, that is RB. I'm going to shift in the same line of action. Then I'm going to draw here, that is RB. Then one more reaction is coming from RA. I'm going to shift in the line of action. Then I'm going to draw here, that is RA. Now I have to find the angle. So RB, if I complete this triangle RB, so this will be 90 degree because tangent and radius. So one more angle if I draw separately, so they given this as 50 degree. This is RB. Then this will make an angle 90 degree because this is tangent and this is radius. Therefore, remaining is 40 degree. Therefore, RB makes an angle 40 degree with the horizontal. Now, I am going to calculate angle of RA. For that, I will draw one more triangle. So, in this case, so we have surfaces like this. So they given this as 40 degree. Then our RA is acting like this. So this is 90 degree. Therefore remaining is 50 degree. Therefore RA makes an angle 50 degree with the horizontal. The last force that is left is RD. So in the previous case we have seen that RD, which makes an angle 50 degree with the horizontal. So I will draw that one. In the previous case, which RD makes an angle 50 degree with the horizontal, but in now it is acting in the downward direction. This is RD now, therefore this is 50 degree. Those are opposite angle. So I can take this RD makes an angle 50 degree. Now after getting all the reaction and angle of reaction, so I have to check the number of forces. Here we have four forces. So that means I can't apply Lamy's theorem. So I have to go for equilibrium condition. So our equilibrium condition, that is summation of horizontal forces is equal to zero, summation of vertical forces is equal to zero. So I'm going to resolve. So first I'm going to resolve that RA in horizontal direction. Angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore horizontal component is RA cos 50. In the first chapter we discussed resolution of forces. You can check that video to understand this concept. Now RB, the angle is given with respect to horizontal. If I resolve, it is going to act in this direction. Therefore that is minus. Therefore RB cos 40, because angle is given with respect to horizontal. So I completed RA and RB. 294.3, it is acting exactly vertical, there is no horizontal component. The left is RD. So if I resolve in horizontal direction, it is going to act like this, that is minus. So angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore RD cos 50 is equal to 0. Now in that RB and RA both are unknown, so I will take this as equation 1, but RD value we calculated in previous step. So I'm going to get one more equation, that is summation of vertical forces is equal to 0. First I'm going to resolve that force RA. If I resolve in vertical direction, angle is given with respect to horizontal. In vertical direction, that is sine component, therefore RA sine 50. RB I'm going to resolve in vertical direction. Angle is given with respect to horizontal, it is moving upward, therefore RB vertical component is sine 40, because angle is given with respect to horizontal. Vertical component of RD, that will be like this. So angle is given with respect to horizontal, I'm resolving in vertical direction, that is acting in negative, that is downward, therefore RD sine 50. So after this we have one more value, that is 294, it is acting downward, therefore 294.3 is equal to 0. I will take this as equation number 2. Now I will apply RD value here. So RA sine 50 plus RB sine 40. RD value we got 225.44, that is minus 225.44. sine 50 minus 294.3 is equal to 0. If I simplify this, I can write RA sine 50 plus RB sine 40 is equal to 467 newton. I can take this as equation 3. Now first equation, I'm going to substitute value of RD, that is RA cos 50 minus RB cos 40 is equal to plus 225.44 cos 50. Therefore, RA cos 50 minus RB cos 40 is equal to 144.9. I can take this as equation 4. Now I can solve equation 3 and 4. So RA we will get 450.88 newton. Then RB we will get 189.18 newton. Here we have our 11th problem. The question is like this: determine the reaction at the surface of contact and the tension in the string AB as shown in the figure. The radius of the spheres, that is all the radius, is 200 mm. Because of this weight that will be exerted like this on these two spheres, so therefore the tension is going to develop in this string. So that is the action. Therefore, reaction on this string I can take in the opposite direction, maybe from this side, from A in this direction, from B in this direction. So from the previous problems we are discussing, if I apply this load in this way, it will be exerted on this sphere. It is trying to pull this sphere in this direction. That is the action on the string. Therefore, reaction on the string in the opposite direction, that will be like this. So I'm going to start with the free body diagram of C. Free body diagram at C. So I will take that point C, then weight of that C acting in downward direction, that is 1 kilonewton. I will take like this 1 kilonewton or 1000 newton. Now I said these are the actions. Therefore, reaction is going to generate from each contact surface in the opposite direction. So I will take this as RQ, then this as RP. So RP I will shift in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here. This is RP. Same way I'm going to shift this RQ in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here as RQ. Now that whatever the weight is acting vertically downward, so I can say this is 90 degree. I have to calculate the angle of RP and RQ. To find the angle of RQ and RP, I will make use of this triangle, that is triangle ABC. Since the spheres are identical, I can say this as 300 mm and 300 mm. Then if I want to find this distance, each sphere is having radius of 200 mm. Therefore, this is 200 plus 200. Therefore, total is 400. If I cut this triangle, if I take this as theta, this will be 300 and 300. If I want to find that theta, I can take cos theta is equal to adjacent is 300, hypotenuse is 400. That means theta is equal to 41.4 degree. So after getting that angle, I'm going to substitute that angle here. This is theta. It is angle of RP. So theta we got 41.4 degree or 41.41 degree. Also, if this is theta, this is also theta. Therefore, RQ also makes an angle 41.41 degree. Therefore, remaining angle, that is this one, I can calculate 180 minus 41.41 minus 41.41, that is 97.18 degree. So total angle here, I can take 90 plus 41.41, that is equal to 131.41. Same way here also, this angle is 131.41 degree. Now I am going to apply Lamy's theorem at C. So known force, that is 1 kilonewton, I will take as it is 1 kilonewton, divided by other two forces RQ and RP, angle between them is 97.18 degree. Therefore sine 97.18 degree, that is equal to second force I'm going to consider RP, other two forces are RQ and 1 kilonewton, angle between them is 131.41. therefore sine 131.41, that is equal to next force, that is RQ, angle between other two forces, for these other two forces RP and 1 kilonewton, again it is sine 131.41. so I can say RP is equal to RQ. To find this, I will consider first two relation or first two equation, that is RP is equal to 1 into sine 131.41 divided by sine 97.18. so we will get 0.756 kilonewton. Also RQ is equal to same relation we are going to get, therefore RQ also 0.756 kilonewton. Now free body diagram at A. So I will take point A, that is here. So force is acting downward 1 kilonewton. So if I check that, it is going to touch two points, that is P and M. Therefore action is towards that point. So my concentration is on reaction. So reaction is coming towards the center of the sphere. So those are two reaction, one is RM and one more is RP. We already calculated that. But in the string, it is trying to pull that string in this direction. So if I apply the load at the top, it is the below sphere is trying to move away from each other. That is the action. Therefore reaction is going to generate like this from A and B also. Therefore I'm going to draw this, whatever coming from RP I will shift in the line of action, then I will draw here, this is RP, then RM I will shift in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here, that is RM, exactly vertical because it is resting on horizontal surface. Then one more reaction in the horizontal direction, so I will take tension AB. If it is string, I will take it as T. If it is support, I will take it as R, that is support reaction. Now I have to find the angle of RP. So if I see in the previous step, So RP is like this. So now it is acting in the downward direction in this way. Therefore, this is theta. With respect to horizontal, theta we got 41.41 degree. So I will write here, that is 41.41 degree. If I check this figure, we have four unknowns. I can't apply Lami's theorem. So I will go for equilibrium condition, that is sigma fx is equal to 0, also sigma fy is equal to 0. That is summation of horizontal component, TAB acting in positive direction. If I resolve this RP, the angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore horizontal component I will get cos theta. Therefore RP, that is acting in negative direction, RP cos 41.41. The other two forces acting vertically, there is no horizontal component, so this is equal to 0. Therefore RP we already calculated in previous step, that is 0.756. So TAB is equal to 0.756 into cos 41.41. Therefore TAB is equal to 0.567 kilo Newton. Now I'm going to apply second relation, that is sigma Fy is equal to 0. So in that we have first component, that is RM acting in vertical direction, I will take it as positive. Then 1 kilonewton acting downward, I will take it as minus 1. So TAB, there is no vertical component because it is acting exactly horizontal. Vertical component of RP, angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore vertical component is sine theta. So it is acting downward like this, therefore minus RP sine 41.41 is equal to 0. Therefore RM is equal to plus 1 plus RP we already calculated in previous step, that is 0.756. therefore 0.756 sine 41.41. therefore we will get the answer for RM. We will get 1.5 kilo Newton. After getting this answer, I'm going to draw the free body diagram at B. Diagram at B, I will take that point B. Force is acting downward, that is 1 kilonewton. So reaction already we done in previous step. This will be TAB. One reaction coming from RQ, that is towards the center of the circle like this, RQ. Then one more reaction is coming towards the center of the circle, that is RN. I will draw here, this is RN. So I will shift in the line of action, this is RQ. I will draw like this, RQ. Then reaction or tension in the string, that is TAB. So we know that with respect to horizontal, so if I check this figure, if I draw like this, this will be theta. I'm going to draw that theta here. So theta value is 41.41 degree. In this case, TAB we already calculated in previous step, that is 0.567. then RQ we already calculated here, that is 0.756. only unknown is RN. Therefore I'm going to consider equilibrium condition sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0. But we, in this case, we don't know Rn. So that is in vertical direction. Therefore, sigma fy is equal to 0, that is plus Rn. If I resolve that Rq, the vertical component is minus Rq sine 41.41. So one more force, that is 1 kN acting downward, therefore minus 1 is equal to 0. So I want Rn, Rq value, that is 0.756. Therefore minus 0.756 sine 41.41 minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore Rn is equal to 1.5 kilonewton. So it will be same as Rm. We already calculated in previous step. Here we have our next problem, that is problem number 12. Determine the reaction at contact points for the sphere A, B and C as shown in the figure. It is given that weight of A and B is 4 kN, weight of C is 6 kN. Then they are given diameter of A and B is 500 mm and diameter of C is 800 mm. So same thing I am going to write in the diagram. So weight of A and B is 4 kN, then weight of C is 6 kN, diameter of A and B is 500 mm, then diameter of C is 800 mm. So first I am going to draw the free body diagram at C. I will take that point C, then whatever the weight that I am going to draw first, that is 6 kN acting downward, then I am going to check the contact point. I will take this as P and Q. So if it is going to touch P, one reaction is coming towards the center of the sphere, that I can call it as Rp. One more reaction is coming towards the center of the sphere, I can call it as Rq. So I will shift that Rp and Rq in the line of action like this. Then I will draw here, this is Rp. Then one more reaction, Rq, I will shift in the line of action. Then I am going to draw here, that is Rq. Now I am going to find the angle. So if I join these points, so this angle I have to calculate. I can take this as theta. So to find that, I am going to draw this triangle. So base of the triangle, they given 600 mm. Now this side, so whatever the dimension, they given it as diameter. Therefore radius from the, if I take this as A, B, C, so this radius will be, diameter is 500 mm, therefore 250 mm. So this is 800 mm, therefore radius is 400 mm. Therefore total distance is 650 mm. So if I cut that triangle, this angle I can take it as theta. Therefore if I apply cos theta is equal to 300, that is the base. So 600 divided by 2, that is 300. Divided by 650. Therefore theta is equal to 62.51 degrees. Same thing, I can take theta here, that is also 62.51 degrees. Therefore, theta we got with respect to horizontal for RP and RQ, that is 62.51. Same way here also, that is 62.51 degrees. So now this angle I can calculate, that is 180 minus 62.51 minus 62.51, so we will get 54.97 degrees. Total angle, so this will be 90 degree, because that force is, because weight is acting vertically downward. Therefore this angle I can calculate, that is 90 plus 62.51, that is 152.51 degree. Same way here I can write, this angle is 152.51 degree. Now I can apply Lamy's theorem at point C, that is 6 kilonewton divided by angle between other two forces. For 6 kilonewton, other two forces are RP and RQ. Therefore angle between RP and RQ, that is 54.97. therefore sine 54.97, that is equal to, one more force I am going to take, that is RQ. Angle between other two forces, for RQ other two forces RP and 6 kilonewton, so angle between them, that is sine 152.51, that is equal to last force, that is RP, other two forces RQ and 6 kilonewton, angle between them is sine 152.51. therefore I am going to consider first two equation. Therefore RQ is equal to 6 into sine 152.51 divided by sine 54.97, that is equal to, answer is 3.38 kilo newton. Now I am going to consider first and third relation, that is RP is equal to 6 into sine 152.51 divided by sine 54.97. If I do the calculation, I am going to get same answer. So after completing point C, I am going to consider point A or sphere A. So I am going to draw the free body diagram at A. So this is the point A. Weight of the object or sphere, that is 4 kilonewton. It is going to contact three surfaces. One is P, then I will take this as M, N. Now one reaction is coming towards the center, that is RP, we already calculated. Then one more reaction coming from M, I can take this as RM. The third reaction that is coming towards the center from N, I can take RN. So whatever coming from RP, I'm going to shift in the line of action like this. I'm going to draw like this, that is RP. Now whatever coming from RM, I'm going to shift in the line of action. I'm going to draw here, that is RM. Then whatever coming from RN, I'm going to shift in the line of action, that is vertically upward. I will draw like this, that is RN. Now I want the angle of RM. for that I'm going to make use of, I will complete this triangle. So tangent and radius is having 90 degree, the one more angle is 75 degree, therefore remaining is 15 degrees, because total angle of the triangle is 180 degree, therefore angle of the RM I will take 15 degree. Now if I see in the previous step, RP makes an angle 62.51 with the horizontal. So if I come draw in the other direction, so with respect to horizontal, again it is going to make an angle 62.51 degree. I will draw here, so RP makes an angle 62.51 degree. So there are four forces, so therefore I can't apply Lamy's theorem, I have to go for equilibrium condition. So first equilibrium condition, sigma fx is equal to 0. Second equilibrium condition, sigma fy is equal to 0. So I'm going to apply first equilibrium condition, that is horizontal component of RM cos 15 degree, because angle is given with respect to horizontal. Horizontal component of RP minus RP cos 62.51 is equal to 0. So RP we already calculated in previous step. So RM cos 15 is equal to 3.38 cos 62.51. So if I do the simplification, I will get 1.615 kilonewton. Now sigma fy is equal to 0. Vertical components are, one is rn acting upward, then vertical component of the rm, if I resolve in vertical direction, that is RM sine 15 degree, so plus RM sine 15 degree. So if I resolve RP in vertical direction, it is acting downward, therefore minus RP sine 62.51, the remaining is 4 kilonewton, it is acting downward, therefore minus 4. So I considered RN, then RM, then RP, then 4 kilonewton. I considered all the forces, that is equal to 0. RN is unknown, I have to calculate now. RM just now we calculated, that is plus 1.615 sine 15 minus RP we calculated in previous step, that is 3.38 sine 62.51 minus 4 is equal to 0. If I do the simplification, RN is equal to, so that is 6.58 kilonewton. So I completed all the forces of point A. Now I'm going to consider point B. So next step, that is free body diagram at B. So I'm going to consider that point B. So weight of the sphere, that is 4 kilonewton acting downward. Now I will take this as point T, then this as S. So it is going to touch the point Q, T and S. One reaction is coming towards the center of the circle, that is RQ. Then one more reaction is coming towards the center of the circle from T. I can take this as RT. Then one more reaction is coming towards the center of the circle from S. I will take this as RS. So RQ, I'm going to shift in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here, that is RQ. Same way, I'm going to shift that RS in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here, that is RS. Then from T, one reaction is coming, that is RT. Now I'm going to calculate the angle. So to calculate the angle of RS, I will complete this figure. So here it is 90 degree. So one more angle, that is 65 degree. Therefore remaining is 25 degree. So total is 180 degree. 65 plus 25, that is 90. So plus 90, it will be 180 degree. Therefore I can take this as 25 degree. RQ we already calculated in the first step. So if I draw in the other direction in this figure, so theta will be this one, that is 62.51 degree. Therefore RQ makes an angle 62.51 with the horizontal. So same thing I'm going to consider here. Now there are four forces. I can't apply Lamy's theorem, so I have to apply the equilibrium condition. So sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0. First, sigma fx is equal to 0. RS, if I resolve in horizontal direction, that will be minus RS cos 25 degree. Therefore minus RS cos 25 degree. So RT acting vertically upward, there is no horizontal component. 4 kN acting downward, there is no horizontal component. If I resolve that RQ in the horizontal direction, that is plus RQ cos 62.51 is equal to 0, because I already considered all the four forces. So RQ we already calculated in the first step, that is 3.38. I'm going to substitute here. Therefore RS cos 25 is equal to, if I bring to the other side, 3.38 cos 62.51. So if I calculate for RS, I have to bring cos 25 to the denominator, I will get, it is 1.72 kilo Newton. Now I'm going to apply sigma fy is equal to 0. So vertical component R, so first RT, it is acting vertically upward, directly I will take. So then one more thing, that is 4 kilo Newton acting exactly downward, therefore minus 4. So vertical component of the RQ, if I resolve in vertical direction, angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore vertical component is sine, acting downward, therefore RQ sine 62.51. Vertical component of RS acting upward, therefore plus RS sine 25 degrees. Sine because angle is given with respect to horizontal, but I am resolving in vertical direction, therefore it is sine. So I want RT value, so minus 4. RQ we already calculated in the first step, that is 3.38. therefore I am going to substitute here, that is 3.38 sine 62.51, RS just now we calculated, plus 1.72 sine 25, this is equal to 0. So only unknown is RT. If I simplify, we will get 6.27 kilo Newton. So I found all the reactions. Here we have our next problem, that is problem number 13. A cylinder weighing 5000 newton and 2500 newton rests on a smooth inclined plane as shown in the figure. Neglecting the weight of the connecting bar, find the force P applied such that the system is in equilibrium. So whatever the connection they given AB, that is connecting bar, or I can say it as rod. So it is not string or any cable. So if it is rod or any bar, it will act as a support. So I will take, if bar, rod will act like support. First I'm going to draw the free body diagram at A. So I'm considering that point A, weight is acting downward, that is 5000 newton. So it is going to connect point C, therefore one reaction is coming towards that center. So I will shift in the line of action. I'm going to draw like this. I will take this as reaction RC. Then one more reaction is coming from this supporting rod. So if it is cable, I can't imagine this system is going to rest like this. Then it will be solid rod or any bar. Therefore, reaction is going to come in the opposite direction or towards the center of the sphere. So I can take like this. So I will take this as reaction AB from the bar. Now I have to calculate the angle. So if I take like this T or RAB, this will be 25 degree, because those are opposite angle. This is 25 degree, therefore this will be 25 degree. So I will take that as 25 degree with the horizontal. So if I complete this triangle, they given this is 60 degree, this is 90 degree, therefore remaining is 30 degree. Therefore angle of RC is 30 degree with the horizontal. Therefore I can take this angle as 180 minus 30 minus 25, that is 125 degree. So weight is always makes an angle 90 degree with the horizontal. Therefore this angle I can take 90 plus 25, that is 115 degree. So this angle I can take 90 plus 30, that is 120 degree. Now I'm going to apply Lamy's theorem about A. So known force, that is 5000 newton divided by other two forces are RAB and RC, angle between them is 125 degree. So therefore sine 125 is equal to, the next force I am going to consider RAB, other two forces are 5000 newton and RC, angle between them is 120 degree, therefore sine 120 degree. The next force I am going to consider, that is RC, other two forces for RC is RAB and 5000 newton, angle between them is 115 degree, therefore sine 115 degree. Now I'm going to consider first and second equation. So reaction in rod RAB, I'm going to get 5000 into sine 120 divided by sine 125. If I do the calculation, that is 5286.111 Newton. So now I'm going to consider other two equations, first and last equation. So we'll get the answer for RC, that is 5000 into sine 115 divided by sine 125. So if I do the calculation, I'm going to get 5531.98 Newton. So this is the first point. Now I'm going to draw the free body diagram at B. So free body diagram at B, I'll consider that point B. Weight of the sphere, that is 2500. Then one P is acting, they given with respect to vertical, it makes an angle 45 degree, that is P. Then I said AB will act like a support, therefore one reaction coming towards the center of B. So I can shift in the line of action, I can draw like this, that is R AB. Then it is going to connect the point D, therefore one reaction is coming from D towards the center. I shift in the line of action, I can draw like this, that is R D. RAB we already calculated, that is 5286.11. P we have to calculate, RD is unknown. So this RD, I have to calculate the angle. So if I see the triangle, tangent and radius makes an angle 90 degree, other angle they given 30 degree, therefore remaining is 60 degree. With the horizontal, RD makes an angle 60 degree. So this point is B. Now I'm going to apply equilibrium condition, therefore sigma fx is equal to 0, then one more condition, sigma fy is equal to 0. First I'm going to resolve. Before resolving, I have to find the angle of RB. If I see the previous step, so this is 25 degree, RB makes an angle 25 degree with the horizontal. Same thing I can take here, that is 25 degree. So first force I'm going to consider, that is RB. If I resolve in horizontal direction, that is RAB cos 25, that 2500 acting in vertical direction. If I resolve this P in horizontal direction, it is going to act like this in the negative direction, therefore minus P. Angle is given with respect to vertical, I'm resolving in horizontal direction, therefore sine component, sine 45. If I resolve that RD in horizontal direction, it is going to act in this direction, minus RD cos 60 is equal to 0. So I considered all the forces. 2500 is acting vertically up downward, therefore no need to consider in horizontal direction. In this case, only known force, that is RAB, we already calculated in previous step, that is 5286.11 cos 25. P is unknown, I will take as it is, minus 45 minus rd cos 60 is equal to 0. I will take this as equation number 1. Second condition, summation of vertical forces is equal to 0. First, I am going to start with RAB. If I resolve in vertical direction RAB, it is acting downward. Therefore, minus RAB sine 25. If I resolve that P in vertical direction, it will be acting downward. Therefore, minus P. Angle is given with respect to vertical, therefore vertical component is cos 45. If I resolve that RD in vertical direction, it is moving upward, plus RD. Angle is given with respect to horizontal, I am resolving in vertical direction, therefore component is sine 60. Then last force, that is 2500, acting in negative direction, therefore minus 2500 is equal to 0. Now I'm going to substitute that RAB value, that is 5286. So minus 5286.11 sine 25 minus P cos 45 plus RD sine 60 minus 2500 is equal to 0. So I will simplify this one. So I will write in this form, RD sine 60 minus P cos 45, constant I will bring to the other side, that is constant is 4734 newton. I will take this as equation number 2. Equation number 1 I am going to simplify. So I will write in the same form, I will multiply with minus, so it will become RD cos 60 plus P sine 45. Minus I brought to the right side, we will get 4790.84. I will take this as equation number 3. I'm going to solve these two equations. So if I do the calculation, RD I'm going to get 6972.66 newton. P is equal to 1844.85. Okay. These are the answers.